Hello everyone, welcome to our English lecture. We'll be doing today fourth chapter of snapshots, that is Albert Einstein at school, right? Now this is written by Patrick Pringle and he's the famous American writer. In this story we see that he is talking about Albert Einstein, and we all know who he is. Okay, he is regarded as the greatest physicist since Newton. Okay, and in this extract, you see, in the following extract from the young Einstein, the well-known biographer Patrick Pringle, he is trying to describe what the circumstances which led Albert Einstein's expulsion from a German school. Okay, so we see that. Albert's father, he was very interested when he had put him in a school that he should at least finish off his diploma and so on, but situation and things were such that Albert Einstein was forced to leave the school, and situations were such that he was expelled from the German school. Now let me go with the line by line explanation from the text. In what year, Einstein asked the history teacher, did the Prussians defeat the French at Waterloo? So a history lesson is going on and the teacher is asking Einstein that which year, when was the time, or where, which year did the Prussians defeat the French at the Waterloo? Waterloo is the battle. Einstein was very plain and a simple sort of a person, so bluntly he replied that he didn't know. I don't know, sir. Then, why don't you know? You have been told it often enough. Teacher is saying, why don't you remember? Often you've been told that when did the French were defeated and, sorry, Prussians were defeated and so on. But then he said that Einstein said he had forgotten it. Did you ever try to learn? Asked Mr. Brown. So, who is the history teacher? Mr. Brown is saying that you say that you don't know and so on. So, did you ever try to learn it? Albert very honestly says that no, he did not. And what did he reply? Replied with his unusual unthinking honesty. Never thought of, never, teacher would not like it and so on. He's saying that in a negative reply he gave, that no sir, I don't know, I've never tried to learn it. Teacher is again asking why not. Then what reply Einstein gives? Einstein says, I can't see any point in learning dates. He says that I don't think that there is any utility, or there is that learning dates is ever useful. And what clarification does he give? He says that whenever we need to know any dates, we can just turn the pages of the book and we can know that know the dates. Mr. Brown, listening, getting this answer from Einstein, he became stunned, speechless. And then what is he saying? You amaze me, Einstein, he said at last. Don't you realize that one can always look most things up in books? He's saying, you really make me spellbound. And then he's saying that, don't you think that anything we need to know, we can just turn the pages from the notebook and textbook and we can know it? What is the use of reading the things and so on? And that applies to all the facts you learn at school. Whatever, why do you come to school then? What is the necessity of teachers and school and so on? He says that we can just know all these things just like that by turning the pages in the book. So why should we need to go to school? He very clearly gave the answer. Yes, sir. Then I suppose you don't see any point in learning facts. So he's saying that, teacher is saying, yeah, then I think that facts and things are also not required to be learned. Frankly, sir, I don't, said Albert. Albert said, yes, even I agree. Then you don't believe in education at all. There's an argument going on with the history teacher, Mr. Brown, and Einstein. They're saying, then you feel that there is no need of education also. Oh, yes, sir, I do. Here he gives a positive reply. He says, oh, sir, I do believe that education is required, but I don't think that learning facts or learning the dates, that is what is education. I have a different definition for education. In that case, said the history teacher with heavy sarcasm. Sarcasm, in a sarcastic manner, sir told him, the history teacher, then perhaps it will be so kind of you. Say, yeah, it will be so kind of you, Einstein, to tell the class the Einstein theory of education in a sarcastic manner. Oh, you believe education and your theory is so on. So I would request you to tell the whole class what is this great Einstein's theory of education. So in a taunting manner, the history teacher tells him. Then Albert flushed. He was worried. What is he saying? I think it's not facts that matter. He knew that he didn't understand the sarcasm of the teacher. So he's saying, yes, sir, I think that facts and things are not more important, but according to me, ideas are more important. That's what Einstein said. I don't see the point in learning the dates of battles or even which of the armies killed more men. He's saying that I don't think for me what is more important, ideas are more important, he's saying. And then he's telling that knowing the dates of the battles, when which army won, who lost, and how many men were killed and so on, why these all things, he says, are not things which interest me. And he's saying why those soldiers were trying to kill each other, why soldiers are fighting, why this war is going on, these dates and things, I don't think these things are useful. That's enough. Mr. Brown's eyes were cold and cruel. Because he was the history teacher and that is what only his subject is concerned about. So he got very wild and then he stopped him. Keep quiet. We don't want a lecture from you, Einstein. You will see in for an extra period tomorrow, today. And what punishment did he give? Today you have to attend one extra period. Although I don't imagine it will do you much good. He's saying that you should stay for an extra period. But even if I'm punishing you, I don't think it will be of any help to you. It won't do the school any good either. You are a disgrace. I don't know why you continue to. The teacher was very angry. He says that it's a shame. You are a shame to the school. And neither you stay an extra period or so on, neither it will be useful for you nor for the school. I just don't understand why you come to school. It's not my wish, sir, Albert pointed out. He's so very, very simple, sober sort of a person. Very innocently said, sir, I don't know. I don't want to come to school. My father wants to send me to school. Then you are an ungrateful boy and ought to be ashamed of yourself. I suggest you ask your father to take you. Say, you are really, if so, then you are no use to the school and you are not grateful to your father also. So I wish you tell your father to take you back. Albert felt miserable when he left the school that afternoon. Not that it had been a bad day. Just both days were bad now. Anyway, but because he had to go back to the hateful place the next morning. After that, the teacher and he, they both separated. But then he was feeling very sad. Not very sad because early morning he came and there was an argument with the history teacher. School that day was not happy. He was not happy in the school. But because after the school, he has to go to the place where he has to go, didn't want to go. That is why he felt miserable or unhappy. But as it is, most of the days it was so. Okay? And which is this hateful place he is talking about? He only wished his father would take him away. But there was no point in even asking. He knew that the answer would be he would have to study until he had taken that diploma. As the teacher said, he was talking to himself that he also always wanted to tell his father to take him back from the school. But it is no use telling him because father will not take him back unless he completes his diploma. Going back to his lodgings, he was staying away from his father. So he was staying in a lodging and that place he did not like. But he had to stay there. Why? Because his father did not have much money to spare. They were not very well to do. And so he was staying in a very small room in one of the poorest quarter of Munich. Where was he staying? In Munich, in a lodging and very shabby and odd, dirty sort of a place it was. He did not mind the bad food and lack of comfort. Okay, food and things, not much comfortable the place. Still he could adjust, Einstein. But what was the thing that did really irritate him? It was what? He hated the atmosphere of slum violence. The place where he was staying, it was in a slum. And the violence, everyday shouting, fighting with each other, beating, that was really irritating. And what is he saying? The landlady always used to beat his children regularly. And every Saturday, the husband would come to the house with a drunk and then he would also beat. This was the violence and this atmosphere really Albert did not like. But at least you have a room of yours. Which is more than I can say, said Yuri when he called round in the evening. The morning was not good. That evening he had a friend named Yuri. He called up in the evening, and then Albert told all these things to him. The deer is saying, at least you have some place to stay. I don't have that even. At least you live among civilized human beings, even if they are all poor students, said Albert. Albert is saying, it doesn't matter. You are staying in a place where poor people are there. At least they are civilized, and I have a place to stay. But here, all uncivilized people. Then, they are not all civilized, Yuri replied. Did you not hear that one of them was killed last week in duel? So they started talking about their own place. No, mine is not good. This is, they are not civilized, this, that. They started talking about both the places. Nothing, of course, he is even proud of it. His only worry is that the authorities had told him not to fight any more duels. He's saying, you don't remember the previous day there was a message that the person had, they had fight and then one of them were killed and all. So Albert is asking, anything fruitful has happened? He's saying, no, the authorities have just given him a warning, and he said that he will not do that. He is upset about this because he hasn't a single scar on his face. Okay, and the person whom it was held responsible, the person is not at all bothered. He's saying the fight was not that useful, I won't say. He was very proud of fighting the things, getting marks and all. But in that duel or in that fight, he did not have any marks on the face or scar on the face. And so he's saying that it is hot on his face to wear for the rest of his life as a badge of honor. That person thinks that if marks are there on the bodies, then cuts are there. When people ask, then you would say that there was a fight and so on. So that would be a respectable badge for him. Ah, say, exclaimed Albert. And these are the students. Well, you will be a student one day, said Yuri. And say, you talk about these people and they say themselves student. So Einstein's friend Yuri is saying, oh, one day you will be also called a student. I doubt it, said Albert glumly. Glumly means in a morose voice, he says, I doubt whether I'll really be want to be a student like that. I don't think I'll ever pass the exams for the school diploma. He's saying, I don't think for me, any time this sort of designation will I get that I'll become a student and so on. And I don't think I'll pass that diploma. He told his cousin Elsa the next time she came to Munich. Normally she lived in Berlin, where her father had a business. And these things, what it, Elsa, Albert had a cousin, Elsa, and she was staying in Berlin. So this same thing he had told to her also. I'm sure you would learn enough to pass the exams, Albert, if you try, she said. And in this conversation, Elsa said, don't worry, at least something you will learn if you pass the exam or if you try to out. I know lots of boys who are much more stupid than you are, who get through. They say you don't have to know anything. You don't have to understand what you are taught. Just be able to repeat it in exam. And this her cousin, his cousin Elsa says that, I know so many boys, they say that you don't have to do anything. Whatever the teacher teaches, you just don't have to understand even. Only you mug up the things and then same thing you repeat in exam and you will get through, means pass the exam. And then Albert said, that is the biggest problem. I can't do anything and learn. I feel learning the things really I am very bad at. You don't need to be good at. Anyone can learn like a parrot. He said, you don't need, that is not a technique. Okay? You can just do it as a parrot does. And this is how his cousin suggested. A book on jewel then would say, what is the one you are reading? He's saying then, the cousin is telling, every time I see, I find you with a book. What is that book you are reading? Then Albert says, it's a book on geology. Geology? Rocks and things? Do you learn that? No, we have hardly any science at school. Then why are you studying? Elsa is saying, I often see with you with a book. And do you study this book? What is that book? He says, it's geology. I learn about rocks and things. So Elsa is saying, do you have that subject? Say, no, no, I just read it. We don't have science at school. Then why do you read it? Sister, the cousin is asking, because I like. There's no good things. I say, isn't that a good reason enough? He said, no, there's no reason to be given. If you like something and if you're doing, I feel that's the best reason. You are right, of course, Albert, she said. But it don't help you in your diploma. It's good that what you like, you do, you read, you entertain yourself. But then your intention, what your father wants to get you a diploma, that will not be fulfilled. Apart from books on science, his only comfort was music. Now, the writer is telling that this sort of person was Albert. Then, other than this, he always was interested in reading books of science. Okay, and other than that, he also enjoyed music, and in that slum area also, often he used to entertain himself by playing the violin. And as soon as he would play the violin, the landlady would come and stop him. And then what would she say? That ailing gets on my nerves. Ailing is that shouting. Your violin shouts in a so vigorous manner, and really I get irritated. This is, there's enough noise in this house with all the kids howling. She would say, so much noise is already there with kids moving here and there, and in the midst of that, your violin also making noise, and really I'm getting irritated. Getting on the nerves is a phrase, that is, I'm getting irritated. And then at this point, Albert really was would get angry, and you say that who made them howl, but he decided it was better to say something. And that when this lady said, he felt like telling her that it is you who make these children howl, but then he did stop. I must get away from here, he told Yuri, after 6 months alone in Munich. It is absurd that I should go on like this. In the end, it will turn out I have been wasting my father's money and everyone's time. It will be better for all if I stop. He's saying that now I'm getting irritated. I should go away from here. And then I know I will not get through the diploma. And then what is going to happen now? It will happen at the end that I have not wasted all my father's money. Then Yuri is asking, then what are you planning to do? How will you try to escape? Then what reason Albert gives? Albert says that, I don't know, but he's saying that if I go to Milan, I'm afraid my father will send me back. He's saying, I don't know what I'll do, but really, I'm not interested staying here and completing the diploma. What he says, if I go back to my father, father is where? In Milan. Remember these places, name. So he's saying, if I go to my father in Milan, he will definitely send me back. And then he, all of a sudden, maybe some idea came in his mind. So he, some glow or gleam was seen in his face. And what is he asking Yuri? Yuri, do you know any doctor? Your friends, do you have any doctor friend? Then Yuri replies, yes, lot of medical students are there. I know them. But only thing is that I never had enough money to go to one. I never went to any of them because I couldn't pay the fees, but I know. Then he's asking, why do you need anyone? Then Albert is giving the idea. Supposing I have a nervous breakdown and this doctor would say that I cannot go to school, I need to get right away from it, okay? And if the doctor prescribed that I am having nervous breakdown and I should be away from school, that would be a good idea. I can't imagine a doctor saying that. Yuri is saying, I don't know any doctor will agree to it or not. But anyway, I will try and ask. I know some doctor. I'll find out a specialized doctor in nerves. Yuri is then again telling that plenty of them are there. But then for a moment he waited, he hesitated for a moment and then added, rather reluctantly. Reluctantly means unwilling. He was not interested or willing to do that. And he's saying, I'll ask some of the students if they know anyone. Say, doesn't matter, I don't know properly anyone, but I'll ask some of them. Will you? Oh, thank you. This at this word, when Yuri had given some confirmation that he will try, Albert's eyes were shining. He felt little bit hope is there for his idea to get fulfilled. Then he asked, wait for a moment. I haven't yet find out. Oh, but you will. And if you say, wait, wait, don't get excited. I have not found out. But then Albert says, I know you will definitely get one. He will, declared Albert. I'm going to have a real nervous breakdown to make it easier for him. And he laughed merrily. He was very happy. He said that, yes, if it is required and get a daughter, real nervous breakdown I'll get. And then there was anxiety, happiness in his eyes, and he felt happy. I have never seen you looking less nervous, remarked Yuri, saying that like you today I feel you are much relaxed. A day or two at school will soon put that right, Albert assured him. Certainly he had lost his high spirits when Yuri saw him next. I can't stand it any longer, he said. I really have a nervous breakdown, and that will satisfy any doctor. Now, next time again when Yuri met him, then Albert is saying that I cannot stand this atmosphere and the things which are taught in the school, and if these things goes on like this, I will really have a nervous breakdown, means I'll go mad, and the doctor will find it easy to prescribe. Keep it up then, said Yuri. I have found a doctor. Yuri said, then if it is so, keep it up and he says that he has got someone who would help out. At this, Albert's face lit up, means he felt happy. "I have an appointment for you for tomorrow evening," Yuri said. "Here's the address." And then saying so, he gave an address to Albert and said that tomorrow evening you have an appointment. And in the paper it was written, Dr. Ernest Well, that was the name of the doctor where Albert has to see. "Is he a specialist in nervous troubles?" Albert is asking. Is he a specialist? No, Yuri said, no, I don't know. But as a matter of fact, he only qualified as a doctor last week. You may even be his first patient. He's not qualified. Or last week only he has got the medical degree. And maybe if it is so, you will be the first patient to him. You knew him as a student then. Saying, I think you knew him as a student. "I have known Ernest for years." Yuri hesitated for a few moments. "He's not a fool," he warned Albert. Said, "I know him since long, but be cautious. He's not a fool. And be careful when you are talking to him." So Albert is asking, "What do you mean? Why are you saying so?" "Don't try to pull the wool over his eyes." This is again a phrase. Means don't try to say the things what is not fact and all. He will come to know. Don't try to hide the things or don't try to lie. That's all. Said whatever is true, be frank and tell him everything. Don't pretend you have got what you haven't. Don't pretend these all things what you have not having. Don't try to hide anything. Not all you deceive anyone. Sorry, not that you would deceive anyone. You are the world's worst liar. They don't try to prove that you are the world's worst liar or things, because he will be able to get everything. Albert, that day, he kept on wondering what he would tell the doctor and so on. He kept on planning and the time of appointment came up. "I don't really know how to describe my trouble, Dr. Well," he began. Now, Albert and Dr. Ernest Well is before each other. And then he went there and said, "I don't know how to describe my problem." Doctor is saying with a friendly smile, "Don't worry. Yuri had told me everything. Okay, and the history of your case I am aware of." "Oh, what did he say?" "Only that you want me to think you had a nervous breakdown." So Albert is asking, "What did Yuri tell you?" So the doctor is saying, "What you expect me to know? That is, you have a nervous breakdown." "Oh dear," Albert's face fell. "He shouldn't have told you that." He's saying, "Oh, did he tell you?" "He shouldn't have." So doctor is saying, "Why? Is it not true?" Saying, "Yeah, it is true." "Then you will say there's nothing wrong with me and you will let me go back." He's saying, "He shouldn't have told. It's true. But then you looking at me, you will say everything is okay. No problem is there. And then I have to go to school again." So the doctor is saying, "Don't be too sure of that. As a matter of fact, I'm pretty sure you are in a nervous state about the school." So doctor is saying, "Don't be sure that I'll prescribe you in that manner, but I think you are in a nervous state," means you are nervous to go to school or you are not reluctant to go to school. Then Albert is saying, "But how do you know all these things?" And wide open, he started staring at the doctor. "I haven't told you all these things, so how did you come to know?" "Because you wouldn't have come to see me about this if you hadn't been pretty close to a nervous breakdown. That's why." So doctor is saying that if it was not so, okay, then you wouldn't have come to meet me. Even if you hadn't been pretty close to, okay, you don't have, but you are close to having a nervous breakdown. And if it was not so, you wouldn't have come to me. And saying so, now he's telling that if I certify that you have a nervous breakdown and must stay away from school a while, what will you do? So he's saying that, what if I certify that you are having a nervous breakdown and you have to stay away from school? Doctor is telling to Einstein. "Oh, then I'll go to Italy," said Albert, "or to Milan where my parents are." "And what will you do there?" He's saying, "I'll go to Italy or to Milan." Then doctor is asking, what will you do going there? "I'll try to get into an Italian college or institute. There I'll go and enter some college or institute." "How can you without a diploma? How can you enter a college? Basics studies is not done. How can you go to higher studies or without a diploma to enter a college or an institute?" "I'll ask my mathematics teacher to give me something about my work." Okay? In school, some hope he had or some likings he had for the mathematics teacher. So he said, "I'm sure my mathematics teacher will certify that I know something and I have learned so many things in maths. okay, they teach at school, and a bit more also I know in maths, whatever is taught in the school. And then he added, when Dr. Well looked doubtful. These all things Albert was telling Dr. Well, and Dr. Well was looking at him in doubt. "Well, it's up to you," he said. "I doubt if it will come off, but I can see you are not doing yourself or anyone else much good by staying here." Okay, so what he's saying, that he went there, and the teacher, he went to the teacher and he's saying that I'll go and ask the teacher all these things, and then "I doubt if it will come off." He's saying, "I don't know, maybe it will be helpful, or what you intend to do will do also, but as it is, staying there, you are not doing good to anyone, and no, neither to you nor to anyone. How long would you like me to say you would stay away from school?" Doctor is asking that, "How long do you want me to certify that you want to be away from school? 6 months will be okay?" Albert was very happy. He says, "Ah, that's very kind of you. It's nothing, I have only just stopped being a student myself." He's saying, "Nothing like that. I was also a student, and just I have stopped from the student's life and I have entered the professional as a doctor. So I know how you feel. I understand the feeling of a student." And then what does he do? He hands over a certificate and wishes him best of luck, the doctor. And then how much? That is, Albert is asking, what's the, how much fee should I give? "Nothing, if I have anything to spare, invite Yuri to a meal." He's saying, "Nothing, I don't need anything, but if you have some money which you can spare, then give Yuri, take Yuri to a meal. He is a good friend of mine, and I think he is a good friend of yours too." Albert had no money to spare, but he pretended he had and took Yuri out to the supper. He did not supper, his night meal, okay, to the meal. "Isn't it wonderful?" he said after showing Yuri the certificate. The certificate was shown to Yuri after they met Yuri and Albert after the meeting with the doctor, and Yuri, Albert showed the certificate. "Yes, it's fine," Yuri agreed. 6 months is a good time, and that will won't actually be leaving the school. So if the worst comes to the worst, you will be able to come back and carry on for your diploma. Say 6 months is a good time, and by then might be you can change your ideas or your mind, and then 6 months is a good time to bring all these changes, and if things goes to the worst, after that you can come to school and join." "I'll never come to that place," Albert assured him, "that never will I come back." And then, "I'm going to take this certificate to the head teacher tomorrow, and I think that will be the end. He will relieve me, and never I'll come back to school." "Don't forget to get a reference in writing from your mathematics teacher first," Yuri reminded. "Before you take this, don't forget to get in writing that from your maths teacher." Mr. Coach willingly gave Albert the reference he wanted. Reference letter, Mr. Coach is the maths teacher he gave. "If I say I can't teach you anymore, and probably you will soon be able to teach me, will that be all right?" he asked. While the maths teacher, Mr. Coach, was giving the certificate, he was asking that, "Will it do? Will it be okay if I say that I am not capable of teaching you? You know more than me what is taught in the classroom." So Albert is saying, "Sir, that's too much. Please don't do that." And it's only the truth. But the teacher said, "That's the fact. It's so you're true. And I'll put it more seriously. It was still a glowing reference," said Mr. Coach, and made the point that Albert was ready immediately to enter a college. It is saying that I'll refer to it because you know much more than what is required. And if it is so, then you will definitely get the chance to enter a college or an institute for higher studies or for higher mathematics. "I'm sorry you have leaving us, although you are wasting your time in my class," he said. Maths teacher says, "I'm sorry you are leaving us, but then as it is, you are doing nothing to yourself or to us. You are just wasting time in the class." "It's almost the only class where I'm not wasting my time," Albert interrupts and says, "Sir, your period or maths class is the only class where I learn something, or I like sitting there. I'm not wasting the time. You wouldn't have asked me for this reference otherwise. I thought you would wonder." "There's nothing to wonder about, Einstein. I knew you were going to leave before you knew yourself." Okay? They say, "Sir, things are not going on well with me," Albert said, "and otherwise your class I enjoyed. I would haven't left." So, maths teacher is saying, "Before you tell me that you are going to leave, I knew that you are leaving." Okay? There's nothing to wonder. Albert was puzzled when the maths teacher said that he knew that he was going to leave. So Albert was puzzled, confused, and saying, "What do you mean, sir?" So he soon found out, before he had a chance to ask for an interview with the head teacher, he was summoned to the head's room. Before the maths teacher could tell anything, someone came and called him. Someone means called him, that head teacher is calling him. "Well, it saves me the trouble to wait an hour outside," he thought. And as he came to know that the teacher had, head teacher had called him, okay, then he was thinking that, good, the teacher called him on his own, okay, I don't have to wait there for 2 hours outside the classroom, means his teacher's room. He hardly bothered to wonder. He didn't so wonder why, what is the reason, why the teacher had called him and so on, okay. And well, he had finished with the punishments. And vaguely, suppose he was to be punished again for the bad work and laziness. Well, he had finished with punishment. So he was wondering whether he has called for punishment and so on. "And I'm not going to punish you," the head teacher said, to Albert's surprise. Albert went there, and then head teacher is telling, "Today I have not called you to punish you or anything for your laziness." Maybe earlier also he been called time and again and punished. Okay, but what is he saying? That I am not prepared to have you here any longer. Einstein, I want you to leave the school now. What is saying? That now anything today, I'm not going to punish you or anything, and I can't wait any longer that you stay in this school anymore. The best thing is you leave the school. "Well, it saves me the trouble of having to wait an hour for or two outside," he thought. He had hardly bothered to wonder why he had been sent for, but vaguely supposed he was to be punished again for bad work and laziness. He was wondering, standing outside the head teacher's room, that why is he called? Maybe he was going to be punished for some bad work or because of his laziness and so on. Then he consoles himself that, okay, doesn't matter. Well, he had finished with punishments. Now, punishments and things are over. As it is, he is going to leave the school. "I'm not going to punish you," he said. The head teacher said, to Albert's surprise, "Your work is terrible and I'm not prepared to have you here any longer. Einstein, I want you to leave the school now." So he now, the head teacher and Einstein is before each other, and the head teacher is telling what? That he was not going to punish him anymore, and his work is so terrible that he has now no longer, the head teacher can keep him in the school. Immediately Einstein should leave. "Leave school now?" repeated Albert dazed. Albert was surprised, listening. "What are you saying? Leaving the school? I should leave the school now?" "Oh yes, that is what I said." Head teacher is saying, "Yes, that's true. What you heard is true. You should leave the school now." "You mean," said Albert, "that I am to be expelled?" So he's asking the head teacher, "You mean you are expelling me from the school?" "Oh, you can take it that way if you wish, Einstein." The head teacher was not mincing words, and the head teacher straight away said, "Yeah, you can take it that I am expelling you, and the simplest thing will be for you to go on your own accord. Then the question won't arise." He's saying, "You can take it that way, but it is better that you take the things as you on your way or as if you like it, so that the question won't arose in that manner." "But," said Albert, "what crime have I committed?" Albert is asking, "Why do you expel me from the school? What have I done?" "Your presence in the classroom makes me possible for the teacher to teach and for the other pupils to learn. So you refuse to learn. You are in constant rebellion. No serious work can be done while you are." What she saying? Your presence itself in the classroom whenever you are in the classroom, it is impossible for the teacher to teach and the other pupil to study, because you are in constant argument with the teacher and your presence only disturbs everyone. No work, serious work can be done when you are there. So it's better you should leave the school. And then at these words, Albert felt the certificate was burning a hole in his pocket. Means he was finding it irritating, because whatever reason he had got the certificate after so much of pain, now it was of no use. "I'm going to leave anyway," he said. "Then we are in agreement at least, Einstein," the head said. Einstein said, "What are you going to expel? I'm as it is going to leave." So the teacher is saying, "Okay, good, we are in good agreement," means we both have the same idea or intention. For a moment, Albert was tempted to tell the man what he thought of him, who, or of his school. Okay, at these words, Albert got irritated and he felt like telling the head teacher what he thought and the other students thought of him and so on, or how he liked the school or what he thought of the school. But then, without telling anything, he proudly held his head high and stalked out. Stalked out means moved out of the room. "Shut the door after you," shouted the head teacher. Head teacher saw that Albert was angry and so on. So he also shouted at him that when you go, shut the door. Albert ignored, did not bother. And then he walked straight away out of the school where he had spent 5 miserable years. And without turning his head to give it at last look, he would not think of anyone. He wanted to say goodbye. He then went out of the school. 5 miserable years he had spent in the school. So he had no attachment or closeness to the school. So neither he felt like giving a last look or say goodbye to the school. But only one person was there. And who was it? It was Yuri. Yuri was almost the only person in Munich he felt like seeing and bidding him bye. Before he left the town, he had come to hate almost as much as the school. Elsa was back in Berlin and he had no other real friends. No one other than Yuri was there. Elsa left away and he had a tough time in the school. Only Yuri was the support. "Goodbye and good luck," said Yuri when he left. They both, each other, Yuri and Einstein, met each other. They wished good luck to each other and Yuri wished that he will have a good or wonderful time wherever he is going, in a wonderful country, and he will be happier there. Wishing so, they depart from each other and the lesson comes to an end. Thank you for watching the video.